Hey everyone, I'm Casey. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you how I made a version of Belle from Beauty and the Beast that's the size of a little statue that can also be used as a hanging ornament. So if that sounds interesting to you, stick around and I'm going to show you exactly what I did.
Make sure you have all the clay and colors you need. Then gather all of your tools together so you know you have them. Use aluminum foil to fill in big spaces and then build the wireframe on top. It makes it lighter and more easy to cover in clay. I put the body tone first because the dress gets built on top of that. Then I just added yellow layer upon yellow layer because a lot of the volume is just the dress. I did this by making large sheets of flat yellow clay that I could chop up and kind of put together like sewing pieces. Then I built her, made sure her face was okay with ears, added the hair, put a lot of detail on the hair because then it makes it look more realistic. This dress also came with gloves. I then realized it also had a bow, so I just fitted one on really, really quickly, and it sticks on pretty nice. Just don't squish down too hard or you can distort the rest of the hair. This dress had a lot of pleats, a lot of detail, a lot is easy to mimic. By just putting some scratch lines in, it makes it look like it has a lot of texture. It's really easy to do. And then you bake as soon as you know it's perfect how you want it. Once it's baked, you can't go back. Then I drew on the facial features with a little pencil, very light, don't dig in at all, and made sure the eyes looked okay because they're really, really hard for me to do. Then I painted with the smallest brush I had because this is a very small statue and it takes a lot of detail. Once I'm sure that the painting was okay, I added some of the sparkle that the dress had. Just needed a little glue and a little sequins. I cut them up, made sure they had the right design, and I really liked how sparkly they were. And this is how it turned out. The dress is really full. You can add a lot of detail with thin pieces, scratching, bows. And now these dresses are really unique, so you can make it any way you like it. Just follow your heart. And that's the best part about this dress.
Thanks for watching. If you liked what I did, please subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be posting videos every week. There should be a link right here on my hand. I'm going to leave that up for a couple of seconds. Also, there's going to be links in the box below, and if you have an idea of what I should make next, please comment. I'd love to try to make new things, and I'll see you guys next week.